Welcome to GeoBiz. Dr. Upendra Singh from NASA Langley Research Center is joining us today at the 10th SPEE Asia-Pacific Remote Sensing Symposium. So tell us, what's the theme this year?
The theme of the remote sensing this year is hazard monitoring and weather forecasting. As you know, that right now the climate change is affecting really in a very extreme way. We are seeing a lot of hurricanes, we are seeing a lot of flooding, we are seeing a lot of weather forecasting has become a problem. So what we are trying to do is to understand at this particular point that what is the genesis of the climate change, how it is affecting this extreme weather. So what we have done, that we have brought people from different continent with a different set of scientists and the technologists. We are posing these problems to them and asking them, first understanding that what event and what kind of physical phenomena is causing this kind of extreme weather, first thing. So once we know the source, then we can do something about it. And the second thing, that how to monitor them. Plus, once you monitor them, you forecast them, how to mitigate those hazard conditions. So that's the focus right now for this particular symposium. But at the same time, we are not looking at one different kind of technology. We have 7 parallel conferences right now running in active, passive, land, atmosphere, ocean. So we are looking at the whole interaction, because they are all coupled. Something happens in ocean, it comes in the atmosphere, it affects the land. So we are looking at the coupled atmosphere and the feedback from different sources.
So tell me, collaboration has been a keyword, it has been a buzzword throughout yesterday. So how important is international collaboration?
As I stated yesterday, that the challenges are very, very urgent and very difficult to overcome. It is not a job of one nation, either in terms of resources or in terms of brain power, in terms of other part, to solve this problem single-handedly. So a commitment and a cooperation and collaboration is needed. The idea with collaboration and cooperation is that we all want to handle this climate change problem. It is not a one country problem, it's a global problem. And since we have the same destination to go, there's no point of taking different path. We can work together, combine our resources, because no country has enough budget to realize all those vision. Plus, it is a cost effective way. The scientists from India, scientists from France, scientists from US, scientists from China, scientists from Japan, they all have different skills, different capabilities. So it is not only the collaboration of instrument, but it's a collaboration and diversity of mind that we are trying to bring in this dialogue. A scientific team and instrument to look at this understanding, because they are very deep and they are very complex.
This is what we've been talking about, the national space agencies. Where do you see a role for the private industry in all this?
In US or even in India, private industries is thriving. If you ask ISRO, they have 20,000 people working. The things which industry can do, government should not be doing that. NASA and ISRO has mind and the brains that they do innovative things. They do the things which is in their arena. But if industry, a very formidable industry, they have capability, we need to transfer those technologies. Once we develop it to the industry, let them become our partner. Because remember one thing, any space agency are dependent on the taxpayer money. It's the tax that, so, if we are working and developing some ideas, concept, instrument, and all those things, we give it back to the industry. Industry make those things. They sell not only to ISRO, but they sell it to other people. That generates revenue. It goes back to the government, and from there it comes back. So this cycle has to be completed. Okay? So when you are giving industry, actually you are getting from them, because that money comes back and that allows you to do the research.
How has the private industry participation been at this symposium? I mean, CubeSats are such a huge thing right now. Are we giving an exposure in that field?
We did bring some of the industry from United States and from France. CNES was here, government organization, they are linked with industry. Then there's another company called STC Corporation from US, they had a booth. But the rest of the things, personally speaking, I had so many chores and so many responsibility that we left that part to the Indian counterpart, because they know the industry much, much better than what I know.
What would you say are the disruptive business models in EO industry right now?
We don't need one big satellite or one big instrument which is costing $2 billion. Can we challenge the great minds at IITs, at Indian Institute of Science, and different institutes to come up with the concept that rather than having one big instrument, we have constellation, we have 50 instruments, and they are all working in formation. You have a small payload, a small launch possibility. Those are the things which are disruptive.
Why don't you tell us about the latest research projects that Langley Research Center is undertaking this year?
So Langley's strength is in our science is two: active and passive remote sensing. We are the lead center for developing the payloads, the instrument, the enabling technology, state-of-the-art technology, right from the concept to the flight. So the Langley, name of Langley is Langley Research Center. We work with other centers. There is no competition per se. We all have certain niche, and we have people, we have skills, we have the world leadership in those area, and we utilize, we leverage. If something is happening at Jet Propulsion Laboratory, if something happening at Marshall Space Flight Center, if something happening at Glenn Research Center, something is happening at Goddard Space Flight Center, we bring those minds, we bring those technologies, we bring those expertise and work together as a unit, as a NASA, as a unit.
I think that should be all. Thank you so much for talking to GeoBiz.
Thank you.